thought when they made this trade, he was going to be the secondary option for the Sixers offensively to Joel Embiid. That's not the case. He's not the number two. That's Tyrese Maxey right now.
I hear you.
And I don't know that James Harden will ever get to a place where he's going to be the number two option on a championship-winning team.
But, CeCe, he is there now. One of the first things I said on our show, this is 2 weeks ago, I'm like, everybody wants James Harden to be the 45-point scorer. Yeah. That guy that has the ball, that played the top pace with Houston, by the way. When there's more pace, there's more possessions in the game.
Okay.
Sixers don't play that way to a degree. What I'm saying is, in order for them to win a championship, you need James Harden to be this James Harden, a facilitator, a guy that pushes the ball, hockey assists, that type of guy. That's what I'm saying. You need one other additional player, which they're talking about getting Bradley Beal so he can be that player all the time.
But here's what I'll say. It's hard to be a facilitator when you can't break down the defense off the bounce and you're the primary ball handler.
But you can if you're involved in a ball screen with Joel Embiid.
You're right.
That's what I'm saying. Like, he's not the guy as a standalone entity right now. That's not his game anymore. That's no longer who James Harden is.
Yeah, I know, but it happened overnight, Jay. It happened so quickly. Because when he went to Brooklyn, we didn't know that that's what he was because you had Kyrie, because you had KD.
100%.
He didn't need to do that.
And he played great, but there was one other element there in Brooklyn.
Shooters.
And, yes, and Chris identified that. Mike D'Antoni, right? So Harden and D'Antoni can roll out of bed with a bunch of shooters and go, okay, let's run our thing, right? Here's, for me, what is going to be the telltale sign. This offseason, let's say Harden opts in and he takes the, whatever it is,
47 million.
Does Daryl,
for that.
You know what? Can we stop right there? Hold on, Max. Let's stop right there. 47.5 million.
Yeah.
And there's a question of whether or not he'll opt in.
Well, when doesn't 200 million so maybe is there.
Doesn't that feel so wrong? I'm just saying.
Feels wrong, but it feels right for his bank account.
Yes.
Yeah, but you just said it though, Jay.
I hear you,
it's
man.
About the value that you get James Harden at. And if
but,
you're down
okay,
more,
so this is where I'm going,
it?
Chris. This is where I'm going. Daryl Morey is extremely rational, right? The way he approaches things. Now, he has an emotional attachment to James Harden. They're boys, right? But it's going to be really interesting, both as a test of Morey's kind of way of doing things and also as a sign for the rest of us. Does Daryl Morey bring in Mike D'Antoni? If he does in the offseason, they get bounced. Let's say Doc is gone. If he brings in Daryl Morey, doesn't that tell you something about what he thinks? What the analytics and trackers say about James Harden?
That ain't his choice. Like, I'm not saying that Daryl Morey won't make the final say, but it's not about being able to get the most out of James Harden. It's about getting the most out of Joel Embiid.
Right, but we'll see what Morey does.
But think about this, though. Like, in D'Antoni's system, when has the big man ever been featured?
Okay, but that will tell us something.
Guys, let me tell you something. As soon as Joel Embiid got hurt, that whole Mike D'Antoni conversation needs to stop. Doc Rivers is going to be the coach next year, unless he decides to go to the Lakers. I'm saying, because you're going to get a pass. Joel Embiid is hurt.
I don't think they're giving Doc a pass.
No, I don't think they're giving Doc a pass.
Mark it down.
No way.
All right, Mark, what's today's date? I'm going to come back May 6, 2022. I'm telling you, when the season starts next year, if he's not the head coach of the Lakers, he will be the head coach of the 76ers.
And I'm telling you this right now, the right man for the Philly job could actually already be in town.
Sam Cassell?
No. The coach that just stepped down from Villanova, Jay Wright.
No.
Well, I mean, Philly and Jay Wright do go together.
Listen, the ownership for the Sixers has had this public love affair with Jay Wright. So I'm not saying that it's going to happen.
I'm just saying
it's a name that it should be considered.
Can I give you a stat?
What's up?
Sixers through two games, okay? Mm-hmm. This is via Sam Quinn, who's on Twitter, right? Someone forwarded it to me. DeAndre Jordan on 30 minutes, okay, is a minus 31. DeAndre Jordan off the court, 68 minutes, Sixers are plus one. The Sixers are plus one without him on the floor. They're minus 31 in 30 minutes with him on the floor. And Doc is the guy who's saying, hey, the guys like him, like his rah-rah, like we're going to talk to my veterans. This is what we want to do.
Mm-hmm.
Is the reason they are stubbornly playing DeAndre Jordan. And much like the bench unit that he played last year in the playoffs, Doc went all bench and it was getting slaughtered. And he was like, nope, this is what we're doing.
So that's
more than even Ben Simmons, why they lost that series last year.
Paul Reed and George Niang is the answer?
Yes.
Okay.
It makes you competitive more than this.
Okay.
More than DeAndre. If you're minus, Jay, you're minus one point per minute.
I get the thing about DeAndre Jordan playing. I get all that. Mm. It's like we're finding something to focus on. But, 76ers didn't have a chance, man, against Miami.
But this is why Doc, I don't think, will be there next year. Not right. Daryl Morey, it's too analytics focused to rock with that.
Yeah, plus Doc had Joel Embiid in when they were up by 20-plus in Game 6 against the Raptors when he got hurt.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.